morning to you all. So today we are going to see the second part of the short story Ranka's Marriage. So if you hadn't go through the first part of Ranka's Marriage video, please go through the video and come back to this part. So before going into the rest of the lesson, we'll see a small recap of our previous class. So the story, it begins where Ranka, the accountant's son, he comes back to his village Hoshali after 6 months. So he had gone to Bangalore to pursue his higher studies. So not many of the people in the village gets this opportunity. So the whole village people, they were very much excited to see Ranka, and they gathered around in his home to see whether he had changed his traditional values or not. But to their surprise, he had not been changed a small thing, but he was the same as he went before he left the village. So now the narrator has beautifully he elaborated about their village. The small description of Hoshali has been seen in the lines. And after that, when he saw Ranka, he started admiring Ranka of not forgetting about their traditional values. So now he wanted Ranka to get married to some girl in their village. But when he asked about the opinions of marriage to Ranka, he got disappointed because Ranka had no intention of getting married to a girl at this point of time. So on hearing that, the narrator got very disappointed, but after chatting for a long time, he made up his mind that he will get him married to a girl of that village. So that's where we stopped, and now we'll move on to the rest of the lesson. Since I was a frequent visitor to Ramarao's place, the girl was quite free with me. I completely forgot to mention her name. Ratna it was. The very next morning, I went to their house and told Ramarao's wife, "I'll send some buttermilk for you. Ask Ratna to fetch it." Ratna came. It was a Friday, so she was wearing a grand sari. I told her to sit in my room and requested her to sing a song. I sent for Ranga. While she was singing the song, Krishnamurti in front of my eyes, Ranga reached the road. He stopped at the threshold. He did not want the singing to stop, but he was curious to see the singer. Carefully he peeped in. The light coming into the room was blocked. Ratna looked up and seeing a stranger there, abruptly stopped. Threshold means a strip of wood or stone forming at the bottom of a doorway and crossed in entering a house or a room. So here Ratna was quite familiar with the narrator as he visited Rama's place very frequently. So the narrator, he thought of a plan to introduce Ratna to Ranka, and he asked Rama to send Ratna to his place as he wanted to send some buttermilk for them. She came all dressed up, and the narrator, he insisted upon her to sing a song while he sent someone to call Ranka. So she started singing, and while she was singing, Ranka arrived at the door, and her melancholic voice touched his ears, and he did not want to disturb the singing, so he stood at the door there, and he was very much curious to see the singer, and very cautiously he tried to have a look, which disturbed the lighting in the room. So on Ranka, she immediately looked up, and on seeing a stranger, she immediately stopped her singing. Suppose you buy the best quality mango, you eat it slowly, savoring its peel before biting into the juicy flesh. You do not want to waste any part of it. Before you take another bite, the fruit slips out of your hand and falls to the ground. How do you feel? Ranga's face showed the same disappointment when the singing stopped. "You sent for me?" he asked as he came in and sat on a chair. Ratna stood at a distance, her head lowered. Ranga repeatedly glanced at her. Once their eyes met, and he looked very embarrassed. No one spoke for a long while. So here the narrator, he compares Ranga's situation to the disappointment of dropping a best quality mango on the floor just before having to truly enjoy it, just before eating it. So it was as if something great had been stolen before one could fully enjoy it. So Ranga, he asked the narrator why he called for him, and Ratna was shy, and she stood there at some distance, and she looked downwards, and Ranga, he stealthily glanced at her. So there was an awkward silence in the room. "It was my coming in that stopped the singing. Let me leave." Words, mere words. The fellow said he would leave but did not make a move. How can one expect words to match actions in these days of Kali Yuga? Ratna ran inside, overcome by shyness. So after things went a bit awkward, Ranka said that he feels it was his coming that stopped the singing, so he must leave. So, however, he did not leave, and the narrator, he made fun of him because he had no intention of going. So he joked about it, and he said that no one cannot expect actions and words match to the Kali Yuga. So after a while, Ranka asked, "Who is that girl, Swami? Who is that inside?" The lion wanted to know. The he goat, who had taken shelter in the temple, replied, "Does it matter who am I? I am a poor animal who had already eaten 9 lions. I have vowed to eat more. Tell me, are you male or female?" The lion fled the place in fear, it seems. "Like the he-goat, I said, what does it matter to either of us who she is? I am already married and you are in the marrying kind." So after a few minutes of awkward silence, Ranga finally asked the narrator about the girl. And now the narrator, he compares the situation with the infamous story of he-goat, and the he-goat means a male goat, and the lion. So he's the he-goat and Ranga is the lion here. So the narrator replies very cleverly and on seeing Ranga's interest in knowing about Ratna. So he says that who she is not of much importance because he is already married and Ranga doesn't have any intention of marrying anyone anytime soon. Very hopefully he asked, "She isn't married then?" His voice did not betray his excitement, but I knew it was there. "She was married a year ago. His face shriveled like a roasted brinjal. "But after a while, Ranga left saying, I must go. I have work at home. I went to a Shastri the next morning and told him, keep everything ready to read the stars. I'll come later. I tutored him in all that I wanted to say. I found no change in Ranga when I met him that afternoon. What's the matter? You seem to be lost in thought. I said, nothing, nothing's wrong. Believe me. Headache? Come, let's go and see a doctor." Shrivels mean shrunken or wrinkled. So hearing the narrator's reply, Ranga got excited, but he didn't show it in his face. But it was quite evident, but full of hope, he asked the narrator if she hasn't married or not. So the narrator replies that probably a year ago she got married, and on hearing this, Ranga got very disappointed and disheartened. So it was clearly all over his face, and he went away quoting some work. So he left the place, and the narrator, he knew that he had some liking in his mind for Ratna, and he went to complete his play. So he went to the village and Shastri, and he told him everything, and he said something in secret, and he came back. Then he met Ranka that afternoon, and he carried the same disappointment on his face. So upon asking if it is a headache or not and what happened, the narrator, he asked him to go and see a doctor because he was looking so dull. "I have no headache. I am my usual self. I went through the same thing when the process of choosing a girl for me was going on. But I don't think that could be a reason for your present condition." Ranga stared at me. "Come on, let's go and see Shastri," I suggested. "We will find out whether Guru and Shani are favorable for you or not." Ranga accompanied me without any protest. As soon as Shastri saw me, he exclaimed, "What a surprise, Shyama. Haven't seen you for a long time." So now Ranga, he says that everything was fine with him and he is very normal. So narrator made a remark that he went through the same feelings when he was seeing girls for himself before he got married, and immediately he mentioned that it could not be the reason for Ranga because he had no intention of marrying anyone. So after that he suggested that they should go and see Shastri to see if the stars means Guru for Jupiter and Shani for Saturn. So he suggested him to go to see Shastri to see if the stars are in their favor. So Ranga went with him, and on seeing Shastri, he implied not having seen the narrator for a long time. And he said that, "I haven't seen you for a long time. Shyama is none other than your servant, the narrator of this tale. I got angry and shouted, what? Only this morning, Shastri completed my sentence. You finished all your work and are now free to visit me. Had he had not done so, I would have ruined our plan by bursting like grains that are kept in the sun to drain. I was extremely careful of what I said afterwards." Shastri turned to Ranka. "When did the young son of our accountant clerk come home? What can I do for him? It is very rarely that he visits us." So here the narrator, he reveals his pet name, that is Shyama. So the narrator, he felt that Shastri was lying because they saw each other in the morning. So he immediately responded, but however, Shastri, he completed his sentence and saved the entire situation. So now Shyama realized what he has just done, and he took extra care from that moment. So now Shastri, he continued his role, and he acted surprised on seeing Ranga. Take out of your paraphernalia. Arangappa seems to have something on his mind. Can you tell us what's worrying him? Shall we put your science of astrology to the test? There was authority in my voice as I spoke to Shastri. He took out two sheets of paper, some cowries and a book of palmyra leaves, saying, "Ours is an ancient science, Aya. There is a story to it, but I won't tell you that story now. This is not a Harikatha which allows you to tell a story within a story. You may get bored. I'll tell you some other time." So paraphernalia means trappings associated with a particular institution or activity that are regarded as superfluous. And cowries means something brightly patterned and domed shell with a long narrow opening. And palmyra means palm tree. And Harikatha means a story of Lord. So here the narrator, he asks Shastri to take out all his tools to help solve whatever going on Ranga's mind with full authority. So Shastri, he took out his essentials and he told them that this is all ancient science, but he won't recite it now because then they both would get bored, but he does not intend on telling it some other time. Shastri moved his lips fast as he counted on his fingers and then asked, "What's your star?" Ranga didn't know. "Never mind," Shastri indicated with a shake of his head. He did some more calculations before saying in a serious tone, "It is about a girl. I had been controlling my laughter all this while, but now I burst out laughing. I turned to Ranga, exactly what I had said. Who's that girl? It was your humble servant who asked the question." So Shastri, now he moved his lips while counting quickly and asked Ranga about the star, and Ranga didn't know about what star he was. And Shastri implied that it is manageable, and he did some calculations. And after some time, he indicated that Ranga had a girl on his mind. So even after trying his mind, Shyama could not able to control his laughter, and he asked a question to Shastri asking about the details of the girl. Shastri thought for a while before replying. "He probably has the name of something found in the ocean. Kamala, maybe." Shastri thought for a while before replying. "She probably has the name of something found in the ocean. Kamala, maybe. Could it be Pashi? Moss? Must be the moss if it's not Kamala. Why not Pearl or Ratna, the precious stone? Ratna, the girl in Rama Rao's house is Ratna. Tell me, is there any chance of our negotiation bearing fruit?" "Definitely," he said, after thinking of some time. There was a surprise on Ranga's face and some happiness. "I noticed it. But that girl is married," I said. Then I turned to him. His face has fallen. Shastri thought and thought, and he replied that a girl is likely to have a name of something found in the ocean. So their guesses included Kamala, Pashi, Moss, Pearl, and suddenly Shastri said Ratna. And all of it came together now to a girl named Ratna, who is the niece of Rama Rao. So that's it. Ranga was thinking about her only. So Ranga was now surprised and happy because Shastri's predictions were right. So he immediately became disappointed when he recalled that she was married. "I don't know all that. There may be some other girl who is suitable. I only told you what our Shastra indicated," Shastri said. We left the place. On the way, we passed by Rama Rao's house. Ratna was standing at the door. I went in alone and came out a minute later. So Shastri said that he did not know all that, and there might be any other suitable girl. So to make it look real, Shastri interfered in their name guessing game and told them that he only told what can be read. So both of them, they left and crossed, left the place, and they crossed Rama Rao's doors, where Shyama went to see Ratna for a minute and he came back. "Surprising, the girl isn't married, it seems. Someone told me the other day that she was. What Shastri told us turned out to be true after all. But Rangappa, I cannot believe that you have been thinking of her. Swear on the name of Madhavacharya and tell me, is it true what Shastri said?" "I do not know whether anyone else would have been direct," Ranga admitted. "There's greater truth in the Shastra than we imagine. What he said is absolutely true." So when the narrator, he came back, he said that fortunately Ratna is not married, and someone might have wrongly said to him that Ratna was married. So the narrator, he expressed his amazement of the fact that he had been thinking about Ratna, and he asked him to swear upon the truth. So to his surprise, Ranga, he told him that told him the truth, that whatever Shastri said was true, and his belief in all the Shastras had strengthened. Shastri was at the well when I went there that evening. So I said, "Shastrigale, you repeated everything I had taught you without giving rise to any suspicion. What a marvelous Shastra yours is." He didn't like it at all. "What are you saying? What you said to me was what I could have found out myself from the Shastras. Don't forget, I developed on the hints you had given me. Tell me, is this what a decent man says?" Now Shyama, he went to see Shastri that evening when he was near the well, and he said about how well he acted what Shyama told him to. So Shastri, he did not like what the narrator was saying, and he said that whatever he said could be very clearly seen in Shastras also, and he completely disagreed with what the narrator said. Rangappa had come the other day to invite me for dinner. "What's the occasion?" I asked. "It's Shyama's birthday. He's 3. "It is not a nice name, Shyama," I said. "I'm like a dark piece of oil cake. Why did you have to give that golden child of yours such a name? What a childish couple you are, Ratna and you. I know, it is the English custom of naming the child after someone you like. Your wife is 8 months pregnant now. Who is there to help your mother to cook? My sister has come with her. I went there for dinner. Shyama rushed to see me. When I walked in and put his arms round my legs, I kissed him on his cheek and placed a ring too on his tiny little finger." So now the story, it goes forward for after so many years. So the narrator, he takes us few years forward where Ranga and Ratna got married happily, and they have a 3-year-old son, and now Ratna was 8 months pregnant. So Ranga's sister had come over to help them to do the household chores because Ratna was pregnant, and it was Shyama's birthday that day. So the couples named their son after the narrator, and it is a common foreign tradition to name your child after someone you truly admire, someone you truly like. So the narrator went there for dinner, and Shyama came running to him only to show his love by holding his leg. So the narrator, he picked him and he kissed him and gave him a ring. "Allow me to take leave of you, reader. I'm always here, ready to serve you. You're not bored, I hope." So here, on saying that, the narrator writes an ending note to all the readers, hoping that they were not bored. So now, as the story is over, now we'll see a small description about the author. So this lesson, Ranga's marriage, it was written by Masti Venkatesha Iyengar, and he was born on 6th June 1891. He was a well-known writer in Kannada language, and he was the fourth among Kannada writers to be honored with the Nanpith Award. So it was the highest literary honor conferred in India. So he was popularly referred to as Masti Kannadada Asti, which means Masti Kannada's treasure. So he is most renowned for his short stories, and he wrote under the pen name Srinivasa. So he was honored with the title Rajasheva Shakta by then Maharaja of Mysore Nalwadi, Krishna Raja Vadiyar. So he died on his birthday on 6th June 1986 at the age of 35 in Bangalore. So students, I hope you all enjoyed the story. It is a very interesting story. Try to read it out again and again, and try to write down a summary on this lesson also. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.